We're almost at 60 degrees, washing away. But look at the suds. You saw how little it was that I put in there, and how little it was to begin with. But that oxy bleach must have foamed it up. At least we know they're getting a good clean. The foam actually looks dirty. Slightly off-white colour. Right, after we've heated, we washed for about 15-20 minutes and we've just clicked onto cooldown. The suds level just touched the top of the glass there, so that was lucky. Any more it could have came out the drawer. Just clicked on to drain. So just remember, it does three rinses and then it does an interspin, and then it does two more rinses. So only one interspin on the synthetic side, or when you press quick, it only gives you three rinses and then a final spin. You can see the foam just dying off there. First rinse with super rinse selected. I'll show you on the next rinse the level it will give with normal, because you can switch it on and off and it does it accordingly. Thank you. Topping up again.
It likes to make sure it's at its level. Five of those, that's fairly decent.
It's taking its time. Quite long rinses actually. I just wanted to show you what to click. There you go.
Hey look, I'm going to press this so you'll get a... I'll show you the normal rinse level.
Rinse 2 of 5.
That's a normal level, it's just sort of just visible.
The mop still looks dirty, but these are years old stains, like, they never come out.
Some unbalanced spins. I'm glad there's only two of them. I Rinse three of five.
We've just finished rinse three. We're still a bit foamier than what I would like. We've still got two rinses to go. Normally the suds would have died off like by now. So we're about to do our first spin in the whole cycle. That's a little bit of theatre for you there. Probably going to get a suds lock. It always does one burst and then a full spin, and it just powers through the suds locks normally. It can be fussy with balancing sometimes. Oh dear. Oh, Jesus. Machine's solid as a rock. It almost cleared it. Normally, it you wouldn't think so, but it actually does clear it just as it's about to slow down. It just spins through it. Right, fourth rinse of five. That hopefully should have helped clear some suds. As you can see, the suds have died down almost completely gone. One more rinse should be perfect. That spin's definitely helped. They're just splashy suds now. Like the water's nearly clear. That's the main thing. Final rinse, number four, taking in the softener slash washer duft, what is it, freshener, it's literally just a scent booster. I've got all four scents, they're not that great really, but for this kind of load it's just going to add something. Just clicked over to number 5, which is long spin. Water's clear enough. Oh, Jesus. Surprised that spun, because it's normally quite fussy. It must know that it's got an awkward load in it.
It's a loud one on spin. Lush, very old school. Right, we've got one more step. I think it's at 1200 and it's got to go to 1400. This is the bit where it doesn't go any higher if it's been unbalanced a few times. But we should get it today. It should go to 1400 in just a couple of minutes. Geez, that was quite a long, intense spin, wasn't it? Pretty decent.
Well, there you have it. That was the Asko 12605 washing machine. I may or may not get some more videos. Depends how I feel. But I appreciate you watching again. Long ass antichrist. Oh. Oh, thank God for that. Right, and that's it all finished. I'm going to put them in the dryer now. The Ariston Active Care. Really cool dryer. Can hear the timeline squealing away there, finishing off. That's came up good actually. That was really dirty before.